Welcome to the tighten your bolts video. First thing we're going to do is we're going to put the chair on its backside like it's popping a wheelie. So what we're going to do is now we're going to take our toolkit. We are going to start with the blue colored hex bolt. We're going to start with the two bolts that hold the front wheel onto the chair. You're going to stick the end of the Allen head into the top of the bolt, righty tighty, lefty loosey. Next, you're going to move to the undercarriage. These three bolts are all the blue hex head. Next, you're going to tighten the footrest. You're going to switch to the purple size Allen head. You are also going to grab your makeshift wrench. You're going to line up the holes on the makeshift wrench that match the size of the nut. And you're going to take the purple hex head, tighten it, and you're going to do that for both sides. Next, we're going to look at the front caster wheel. There is one bolt holding that wheel onto the frame. Same purple head. You are going to tighten that bolt, take the makeshift wrench, and put that on the nut. You're also, while you're here, you're going to spin the tire of the caster wheel. It should free roll like this. That lets you know that the wheel bearings inside the tire are functioning. If it doesn't turn, then you'll need to take the tire out and the wheel bearings will then need to be replaced. But that is a super simple fix. Next, we're going to move to the other side of the chair and we're going to start with the wheel again. Next, we're going to move to the footrest on the opposite side. Use your makeshift wrench. And again, with the purple, once this is tight, you will notice that the footrest will be able to fold and unfold with more resistance. If you cannot get this tight, then there may be broken washers inside those two bolts. Next, we're going to switch to the blue hex head, and we're going to tighten the three bolts on the left side of the chair. Left and right are always from the user's perspective, the person sitting in the chair. Once you tighten these three bolts, make sure those are tight, and we can move on to the next section of the chair. With the chair still in the wheelie position on its backside, it's now time to tighten the four bolts that hold the seat cushion in place. We're going to take our toolkit. We're going to grab the pink Allen that has the Phillips head on it. The Phillips head is what's needed to tighten the four bolts that hold the seat cushion onto the frame. As a factory, we do not glue these four bolts in place because a lot of our customers struggle from incontinence or little bathroom potty accidents. So you don't want these bolts to be glued in permanently. If you need to, at any time, remove the seat cushion so that you can spot clean it. If incontinence is not one of your ailments, feel free to put a little dab of Loctite on these screws and glue them in. Once they are glued in, they will never remove. So just make that decision on your end, what is best for the seat screws. But this is how you will tighten those bolts once a month. With the chair still in the wheelie position, it's now time to tighten the footrest pad. There are three straps. Each strap has two screws. We are going to continue using our Phillips head pink tool from our Fold & Go toolkit. You will tighten each one of these six bolts, two on each strap. If at any time your footrest becomes crooked, this will be the time where you can realign it onto the frame. But this acts as the little front bumper for your wheelchair. Reposition the chair so it's back on all four tires. Now we're going to look at the armrest and seat base bolts. There's one bolt going through each of the armrests that hold it in place. We recommend removing the backrest cushion. It Velcros on and off. We recommend removing it for the first time just so you can see and get used to what you're doing. We're going to use the purple Allen. You're going to put one end in the bolt and use your makeshift wrench on the other end. Righty tighty, lefty loosey. You're going to repeat this for both sides of the chair. After you've done both of the armrests, then we're going to go right below it to the seat base. This is where your seat cushion attaches to. We are now going to switch to the larger size, the blue hex bolt. You're going to put that into the top of the bolt head and use your makeshift wrench again on the seat base. Tighten both sides of the chair for these four bolts in total. Next, we're going to tighten the armrest pad and joystick bolts. You're going to flip up the armrest. You will notice the two bolts that attach the armrest pad to the frame of the chair. You're going to take your Phillips head pink tool and you're going to stick it into the head of each of these two screws that hold the armrest pad on. Again, righty tighty, lefty loosey to tighten these in place. After you've tightened both of these, you're going to move up to the two bolts that hold the joystick into the armrest, either on the left side or the right side. You're going to use the same Phillips head and tighten those two bolts. After you've tightened the bolts on the joystick armrest, you want to look at the cable, the quick connect. That is the cable that you can disconnect to remove the joystick at any time. You want to make sure that this cable is flush with the frame of the chair. We do this is because that armrest is the exact same height as a doorknob. So when you are going into tight doors, bathroom doors, exterior doors, we don't want it to drop down and catch on the doorknob. So just make sure the cord is on the inside and flush with the chair. Once you do the joystick side, then you're going to do the opposite side. Now we're continuing to move towards the rear of the chair. We are looking at the rear folding hinge bolts. Those are right in front of the frame lock. You're going to want to position the chair partially closed. You're going to make sure the backrest is not straight, but it's pushed forward a little bit. This will give you a better angle to get those bolts. Again, we are going to use our purple hex bolt, and we're going to line up the makeshift wrench with the bolt size. Righty tighty, lefty loosey, you're going to do both bolts, one on the right and one on the left. These bolts will also right in front of the red springs, so that will help you find exactly where these bolts are at. To wrap up our tightening the bolts, we have the rear remaining bolts. Majority of these you will not have to tighten on a monthly basis, but you do need to spot check them. First, we're going to start with the frame lock. You should make sure that when the chair is unfolded, you cannot unlock the chair. If the lock is too loose, you'll need to tighten the bolts on both of these sides that hold the bars that hold the frame lock. Next are the red seat springs. These you should spot check. That red spring, the tension of it should fill up in between the frame pieces. You should not have a gap under the spring to the bottom frame piece. Next, we're going to move to the lug nuts on both sides of the chair. This very large lug nut, you rarely have to tighten, but you should spot check. Next are the bolts that mount the frame to the motor wheel. There are also, you're going to notice, the bolts on the motor wheel housing themselves and the tire, the rim and the tire. Those bolts you do not need to tighten. We have already taken care of that at the factory. But please spot check just to make sure they're not backing out for whatever reason. The last bolt you're going to look at is right by where the cables are zip tied. You're going to spot check both of these bolts. If there is a gap, make sure to tighten those up. This concludes the video. After watching this, if you have any additional questions, feel free to contact our service department. I want it all.